Hey guys, welcome back to another video. This is the first football video of the year. Honestly, it might be the only time I've done anything besides high school football back when I was a senior in high school and I did those videos for a year. Honestly, besides that and training camp videos, I don't think I've done anything football related. So this might be a first. For college, anyway, for college football in general, because for NFL, I've done, as I said, I did the training camps and I've done high school, back when I was in high school. So, yeah, it's my first college, game doing a video on it. Just starting to go to the stadiums. I was going to say just getting into, but I've been into college football for a while. It's just, haven't gone to many stadiums. It's going to be a lot of FCS. You're not going to see any FBS, but you are going to see, as I said, FCS. And going into basketball season, you'll see a few Division I college games as well. So look forward to that. This is Lafayette from September 28th, 2019. They are playing Penn, the Penn Quakers. And, of course, this is going to be a stadium tours video of Fisher Field at Fisher Stadium, two completely unrelated Fishers, by the way, in there at Fisher Field in Easton, PA, just up the hill from downtown. And it's a pretty nice campus, honestly. In this, you can see the arena in the background. There's this giant hall-looking thing that's their athletic center, basically. That's where the basketball court is. You will see that later in the year when basketball season comes around. But as for this, it's a really cool-looking stadium. It's kind of what you expect from FCS rather than FBS, but at the same time, for what it is, it's pretty cool. The concourse, there's two levels of concourses. The one underneath, because it's on a hill, the one underneath is pretty cool because there's just this layer of rock on one side and then this little fence in between you and the rock so that, you know, avalanches and stuff. But it's really cool. Other than that, any real notable stuff that you won't see in the video? I'm not really sure. Yeah, you'll just see for yourself. But anyway, and as always, once I'm done showing, all the stadium stuff is done pregame, and then after that, you will see highlights of the actual game itself. If you're not familiar with my stadium tours videos, and if you're still watching this part after me rambling for almost 3 minutes. Anyway, that is it for me. Also, at the end of the video, of course, I'll have the stuff that I got there, which includes t-shirt, hat, program, all that stuff. So anyway, thanks for watching, and enjoy the video.
Basically the stadium part of that.
Yeah, I can see some seating right there. I think that's the away seating, I see.
But I knew...
The lights are on. You got this.
Practice ball that way. Cool down here.
This may be all closed. Besides the restroom.
One, two, three, four.
Just a little off to the side. That's all. Yeah, I think that's 7. This is 8. And 9 should be right here.
This definitely does have a different feel than any professional stadium.
If in these were our seats.
As we honor America and those who serve and protect it with the singing of our national anthem. As a part of Lafayette's homecoming weekend, leading us to the Star Spangled Banner, the Lafayette Concert Choir. the Lafayette College Concert Choir. 25 years, Jim Daly. As we celebrate Jim's tenure at Lafayette College, and also please welcome Caleb Mader. Lafayette's captains are number one, Yasir Thomas, and number 75, Jake Marotti. The captains for Penn are number 14, Sam Filippi, and number 30, Perkin Brooks.
Penn has won the toss, elected to defer.
Freshman Joe Gillette and number 28, junior J.J. Younger. Kicking off for Penn, number 93, Drew Brennan. Lafayette is proud to host Caleb Mader, along with his parents, Brad and Katie, sister Allie, and brother Lucas, a new football fan. A huge football fan, Caleb has ended and joins us today to help raise awareness. One more time, let's give a nice warm picture. Stadium welcome to the Mader family. To donate $25 to Coach to Cure MD, text the word CURE to 501-501. First and 10 from Quaker 40. Gay on the carry, gain of a couple. Second and 7 from the 37. Shoemaker connects with number 18, Julian Stickner. Third and 3 from the 33. Fourth down and three on the Quakers 33-yard line. Leading the defensive effort for pass number two, Shaheed Lunican. Attention fans, we direct your attention to the 20-yard line on the Lafayette sideline closest to Perver Varsity Football House. That's where Lafayette Director of Athletics, Serena Freeman, is joined by several special guests. Lafayette is proud to honor head swimming and diving coach Jim Daly for 25 years of service to the college. Jim is surrounded by his family, members of his team, and many alumni from the swimming and diving team. Congratulations, Jim, and go Leopards! Ryan Craig, first down Quaker. Robinson's pass is complete. Second and 10 from the 23-yard line. Ryan Glover on the carry.
Penalty game, is it?
Tackling behind the line by number 42, Major Jordan. Penalty marker on the play. Formation on the offense, 5 men in the backfield. The penalty is declined. Third down. Robinson on the carry. Tackle made by Ryan Zickens. Penalty marker on the play.
Holding. Offense, number 70. A penalty is declined. Fourth down.
First and 10, Quaker from the Lafayette 44-yard line. Robinson's pass is caught. By number 89, Ryan Freeman for a Quaker first down. First and 10, Quakers from the Leopard 21-yard line. Brooks on the carry, met by Lafayette's number 26, Marco Olivas. Second and one from the 12-yard line. Brooks on the carry, stopped by number 93 for Lafayette, David Washington. First down, delivering the first goal from the league. Trey Flowers with the football for the Quakers. Second and goal from the Lafayette 4-yard line. Brooks on the carry. Met by the Leopard Rutland.
Uh-oh.
Robinson connects with number 89, Ryan Craven, for a Penn touchdown. The extra point is good. With 8:04 remaining in the second quarter, the score is 10-7, and Lafayette 3. Eventually brought down by the Quakers number 36, Adam Conyer, the Leopard first down. Dayton Sutton. Second and three on the Quaker 42-yard line. Shoemaker connects with number 8, Grin Lemire, for another Leopard first down. Connor O'Brien defending the play for the Quakers.
Injury timeout.
Hunter Hayes for the Quakers.
Touchdown, Leopards!
Survey for the 85 playoff shot. From the Leopards' 48-yard line. Ooh. Robinson passes tip and incomplete. Leopards' 48-yard line. leopardlake.lafayette.edu to register, and go Leopards! At number one for Lafayette, senior defensive back, Yasir Thomas. Brooks on the carry, makes his way down to the Leopards' 34-yard line. For a Quaker, first down. Tackle made by the Leopards, number 33, Ryan Dickens. First and 10 from the Lafayette 34. Brooks on the carry, met by Lafayette's number 97, Ryan Barnett. Robinson connects with number 89, Ryan Cragen. For the Leopards, number 93, David Washington. Robinson completes the pass to Brooks. Met by Caleb Burr. It's a Quaker first down. First and 10-10 from the Lafayette 20-yard line. Brooks on the carry, brings the ball down to the 15-yard line.
Penn uses its second timeout of the half.
Touchdown Quaker, Robinson to number 89, Ryan Cragen. Defending the play for the Leopards, number 24, Eric Easton. The extra point attempt is good. With 14 seconds remaining in the first half, the score is 10-14, Lafayette 10. Lafayette 25-yard line. Troy. Shoemaker's pass complete to Nick Pearson. First and 10 Leopards on the Quaker 41-yard line. Shoemaker brought down behind the line of scrimmage by number 23.
The end of the second quarter.
Zach Evans on the tackle. At the end of the first half, the score is 10-14, Lafayette 10. The 2019 Lafayette Dance Team. Level up, Leopard! Are presented by RCN. RCN, connect to something more.
The best body part you could ever have is the one that you're doing. Not only do you have to get the support and the
people. Number 38, Jeffrey Gordon. Jason McLeod with the return for the Quakers. 45-yard line, where he's met by Lafayette's Caleb Burr. That's a Quaker first down. First and 10 from the Lafayette 45-yard line. Brooks with the football. Robinson's pass is incomplete. Intended for a 43-yard line. Brooks on the carry. Oliva. Now bring up fourth down and one. The Leopard 36-yard line.
Brooks is stopped by Lafayette number 26, Marco Oliva.
Illegal substitution. Defense. 5-yard penalty. Results in the first down.
Robinson connects with number 89, Ryan Craven. Wrapped up by Lafayette number 26, Marco Oliva. Leopard 45-yard line. Connects with number 11, Tyler Herrick. Tackle made by Lafayette number 23, Romeo Weichel.
They didn't get done moving the markers.
Robinson,
they snapped the ball.
Brooks on the carry for 10. Leopard 42-yard line. Brooks off the carry. Aggers punt rolls inside the 5-yard line. And it'll be first and 10 for Leopards. On the field is first and 10 from the 42.
and pass incomplete to number 11, Tyler Harris. Quakers at the Lafayette 17-yard line. Brooks on the carry. Brooks with the football. Robinson's pass is complete to Brooks. Robinson stopped behind the line of scrimmage by number one, Nasir Thomas, and number 30, Caleb Bird. Robinson's pass is complete to Herrick. Touchdown 10, Harrison Brooks. The extra point attempt is good. With 11:36 remaining in the fourth quarter, the score 10-21, Lafayette 10. That's number 23 for Penn, running back Trey Flowers. Five on the Penn 48, on the Leopard 48. Willows on the carry, brought down by Lafayette number 33, Ryan Dickens. Brooks on the carry, brought down by the Leopards number 24, Eric Mitchell. At the Quaker, first down.
Injury timeout.
That's Lafayette number 33, Ryan Dickens, junior linebacker. Brooks on the carry, stopped just shy of the goal line.
False start, offense, number 71, 5-yard penalty, first down.
First and goal from the seven. Brooks on the carry for the Quakers. Fumble on the play, picked up by Lafayette number one, Nasir Thomas. J.J. Younger got near the line of scrimmage. Second and 11 from the 11.
Third and 17 on the 36-yard line. Shoemaker's pass is ended for number 3, Julius Leon, incomplete. Fourth and 17 from the 36.
Okay, so this is everything gotten from the Lafayette Penn game on September 28th, 2019. Let's just get on into it. So first we have the printed ticket stub here. As you can see, Leopards football versus Penn. And then, you know, you just have your standard stuff. It's just your standard printed ticket. Not a whole lot. Nothing on the back. I'm going to do this last because it's a program. You can see how many pages are in it. But with this stuff, as customary, when I usually... That's not related. As customary, when I go to a new stadium or whatever, I get the hat and shirt of whatever team I'm visiting. So here we have Lafayette football with the logo on it. Obviously a leopard. And really that's the only thing on it. You have Nike logo, dry fit, but you know, it's not really that important. You have the hologram on the bottom. That's a collegiate license property. So, and this is the shirt that I got. Pretty plain and simple. Just Lafayette football in red. Red letters, the white outline, Lafayette football in a gray shirt. And, really, there's nothing else on it. Nothing on the back or anything. Ooh, I just hit that sign up there. Anyway, last thing here is the program. $5 program. And it is one of those where they do have a different program for every game. Because this one is specifically versus Penn on that day, 3:30 p.m. And apparently it was homecoming as well. That's right, I think it was. But, you know, they didn't make too much of a deal about it. So, as I usually do with these kinds of stuff, it is actually a pretty large program. So, I'm going to flip through, pause if you see anything interesting. But, you know, I'm not going to go over everything. Of articles. These are, I guess, you know, main people in the Lafayette world. Head coach. Assistant coaches. Oh, come on. There's a page that's stuck together that won't come unstuck. There it is. We're still on coaches, I think. Yeah. Because now we're getting into the player captains here. Ads. Here's your full roster. I'm not full on this page, but it continues. With some added pictures as well of the team. Oh, why are these pages so hard to flip? Something over there. Then friends of donors. Friends of football donors. You have an article over here. All these pictures, or most of them, besides the ads, seem to be in black and white. Here's your roster of, you know, just like this, with the names and numbers and positions. And then here's Penn over here. So. Actually, they have another roster over here. And there are statistics over here on this page. And then here's Penn's roster. What was the point of that last page then, if they're just going to show the rosters again? Penn statistics over here. Oh, I hate these pages. Okay. That's not an ad. It's just basically, it kind of is. But it's saying University of Pennsylvania and like kind of a bio about it. It's not necessarily an ad, but the reason why they put it in there is obviously because that's who they're playing. Lafayette cheerleaders, Lafayette pep band, Lafayette dance team. And here's your ads. Friends of Lafayette football. Scholarships. Sponsory player. I'm skipping pages again, I think. Okay, this page is just all ads. Lafayette. God, these pages are getting really annoying. Fisher Field at Fisher Stadium. Those two Fishers are completely unrelated, by the way. There's some pictures with some captions there. Varsity Football House. So that's some more pictures of everything here. Add. Maroon Club Hall of Fame. Basically, I assume former players and stuff. Okay, more ad. About the Patriot League, it looks like. Ad. Following the Leopards. Talking about TV, social media, live stats, stuff like that. Lafayette versus Lehigh, the rivalry. Faculty mentors. Cool. Official football signals of the ref. Fall sports update. Guess all their other fall sports. And then ad, and then we're done. Then we have a TV remote to look at. But yeah, that is pretty much it. Sorry, if especially at the beginning of that program, if like the right side of the pages you couldn't really see, just because like shadows and stuff. If you didn't notice, toward the end I tried lifting the page a little bit so that was in the sunlight. I don't think I missed anything too important by like shadows and stuff, but I might have. I don't know. Anyway, that is pretty much it for me. Thanks for watching, and I will see you all later.